Good morning, all of you. So, in our previous class, we had completed the chapter heat and we had discussed a lot of concepts in that. Okay. Initially, we had discussed related to experiments related to hot and cold objects. Then we had studied how measuring of temperature is done. Then we have studied how to read a thermometer. We have studied different types of thermometer. Then transfer of heat. In that mainly we had studied conduction, convection, radiation, and then we had studied sea breeze, land breeze, and then what kinds of clothes usually we wear in summer and winter. Though it was a lengthy lesson, it was very interesting, and many of the things we came to know and we came to understand. So today let us continue with the solutions of this chapter. Let us see question number 1. State the similarities and differences between the lab thermometer and the clinical thermometer. So what are the similarities? The similarities are that both clinical and lab thermometers have long, narrow, uniform glass tubes. The buds of both the thermometers have mercury in them. Differences. The temperature range of clinical thermometer is from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius, while that of the lab thermometer is minus 10 to 110 degrees Celsius. Clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of human body. However, lab thermometer cannot be used to measure the temperature of a human body. The least count of both the thermometers differ. Least count means the minimum number which we are taking. Unlike clinical thermometer that can be tiled, lab thermometer is kept upright while reading the temperature values. So these are the differences and similarities. Question number 2. Give two examples of conductors and insulators of heat. As you know, what are conductors? Substances that allow allow heat to flow through them. They are conductors, like aluminium and iron. Insulators will not allow heat to flow through them. They are wood, plastic, etc. Okay, so let us see the next question. Question number 3, fill in the blanks. The hotness of an object is determined by its dash. Temperature of boiling water cannot be measured by a dash thermometer. You can guess the answers. That's why this is blank. Next slide, I will show you the answers. Temperature is measured in degree dash. No medium is required for transfer of heat by the process of dash. A cold steel spoon is dipped in a cup of hot milk. It transfers heat to its other end by the process of dash. Clothes of dash colors absorb heat better than clothes of light colors. So just let us check the answers. The hotness of an object is determined by its temperature. Temperature of boiling water cannot be measured by clinical thermometer. Temperature is measured in degree Celsius. No medium is required for transfer of heat by the process of radiation. A cold steel spoon is dipped in a cup of hot milk. It transfers heat to its other end by a process of conduction. Clothes of dark colors absorb heat better than the clothes of light color. Okay. Question number 4, we have to match the following. So just let's check the answers. Land breeze blows during the night. Sea breeze blows during the day. Dark color clothes are preferred during winter. Light color clothes, they are preferred during the summer. Question number 5. Discuss why wearing more layers of clothing during winters keep us warmer than wearing just one thick piece of clothing. Because during winters, we prefer wearing more layers of clothing than just one thick piece of clothing because air gets trapped in between various clothing layers. Being a poor conductor of heat, air prevents heat loss from our body. Hence, layers of clothing keep us warmer than a single layering. You have to look at the figure and you have to mark where the heat is being transferred by conduction, by convection, and by radiation. So you can see in the answer only, it's written. Transfer of heat from burner to the pan, it is by radiation. transfer of heat from pan to water is by conduction. Transfer of heat within water is by convection. Question number 7. In places of hot climate, it is advised that the outer walls of the houses be painted white. Explain. In places of hot climate, it is advised to paint the outer walls of the houses white because a light color such as white reflects back more of the heat that falls on it. Hence, a light color tends to keep the house cool. Question number 8. 1 liter of water at 30 degrees Celsius is mixed with 1 liter of water at 50 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the mixture will be A. 80 degrees Celsius, B. more than 50 degrees Celsius but less than 80 degrees Celsius, C. 20 degrees Celsius, D. between 30 and 50 degrees Celsius. So the answer is the temperature of the mixture will be between 30 degrees Celsius and 50 degrees Celsius. An iron ball at 40 degrees Celsius is dropped in a mug containing water at 40 degrees Celsius. The heat will flow from iron ball to water, not flow from iron ball to water, or from water to iron ball. Flow from water to iron ball. Increase the temperature of both. So the correct answer is B. The heat will not flow from iron ball to water or from water to iron ball as both the substances have same temperature. Once the transfer of heat occurs, then the temperature of both substances, they become same. Then the heat will not be transferred. Question number 10. A wooden spoon is dipped in a cup of ice cream. Its other end becomes cold by the process of conduction, becomes cold by the process of convection, becomes cold by the process of radiation, does not become cold. So the answer is D. Its other end does not become cold as wood is the bad conductor of heat. The next question. Question number 11. Stainless steel pans are usually provided with copper bottoms. The reason for this could be that copper bottom makes the pan more durable. Such pans appear colorful. Copper is a better conductor of heat than stainless steel. Copper is easier to clean than the stainless steel. So the answer is C. The reason for this is that copper is a better conductor of heat than stainless steel. So these answers you are supposed to write on your own. Okay. So you just in one or two lines you will write the answer. What are the following? What is conduction? Yes, conduction is the transfer of heat occurring from hot end to colder end. Convection, transfer of heat in liquids. Okay, where the hot part of the liquid rises up and the cold part takes its place. Radiation, where the heat is transferred in gases from one place to other. Thermometer, thermometer is the device used to measure temperature. Temperature is the measure of hotness or coldness of a body. Land breeze. Okay. What is land breeze? Land breeze is the air that is blowing. Land breeze. What is land breeze? Land breeze is the air that is moving from the land towards the sea. It is the cool air. Then what is sea breeze? The warm air from the land moves towards the sea. Okay. This is called as the sea breeze. Sea breeze occurs during the daytime and land breeze during the so this is what you need to remember. Okay. So I hope you all understood. You have to define this all together. Okay. With this, we are going to end our today's class. I hope you understood what is heat and what is coldness. Okay. Thank you. Waiting for the online session. In the online session, we will be clearing all our doubts related to this lesson. Okay, bye all of you.